right there, this is your enemy. Your brother with this skin is not your enemy. Other white people are not your enemy. What's your enemy is racism. Racism is your enemy. Racism is stopping you from getting jobs. Racism is stopping you from climbing the ladder. Racism has indoctrinated you into hating your brother. We're at the bottom of the ladder, bro. And all we want to do is climb the ladder and feed our family. Have respect. Do you understand? Not get more sentences than the next man. If I do a sentence and this guy over there does a sentence, why should he get less than me? Why does he get probation and I automatically get custodial? Like, this shit needs to stop. It really needs to stop. Do you understand? Like, for the Asian man then, this racism is not just a black man's battle. It's our battle. We all went through it together. When there was Paki bashing and doing all that shit and nigger bashing, we felt it for you. But we made it easier because we warred with them. You guys didn't war with them. We warred with them. So why is it always that we've got a war to make things easier for you? Let me touch on the subject. They fear this skin. Yeah? That's why they don't let us in. They only let you in because they can control you. Yeah? You're their puppets. We're not. Because they can't control us. Yeah? So if you feel that you've got better jobs, better housing, better positions than us, it's only because they can control you, is why you're there. But you're only going to reach to a certain level. You're never going to reach way up there. Ever. Ever. You see what I'm saying? But this is racism. Yeah? This is what we're dealing with when we talk about racism. Yeah? To the footballers. Now, I know it's not every footballer that's a racist. I know that there's a hell of a lot of footballers out there that can't stand the monkey chants, the bananas getting thrown on the streets, thrown on the pitches. Do you know what I mean? Like Raheem Sterling will score a goal for you. We will take England to the next level. Yeah. But then you've got people dissing them. How does that work? So to the footballers that don't like racism, to the footballers that don't like racism, come and stand with your brothers. Come and stand shoulder to shoulder with us. Yeah? And let's show in the face of racism that we're not having it. London, like, all right, cool. When I was growing up, there was places in London, yeah, that you weren't allowed to go. No-go areas like Bermondsey, like Canning Town, like Dagenham. Do you understand? See, to name but a few places. London is not like that no more. London's multicultural. There's not a place a black man, Indian man, any kind of man can't go. You feel me? We could go anywhere. Plumstead used to be bad, really, really bad. But you go to Plumstead now, it's full of Somalians and all that. Somalian brothers, I want to see you there. Yeah? Because you never went through what we had to go through. We made it so you didn't have to go through what we went through. Do you understand? Yeah? This skin, we warred, we suffered, we've done all this, and we're still doing it now. You understand? We're only doing it against the racists. Do you see what I'm saying? How about Winston Churchill? I don't care about his statue. I don't care if you want to come and protect his statue. You can do that all day long. In history now, it's going to go down that Winston Churchill was a racist. Not that he was the greatest thing that England ever produced and he's done the World War, whatever. So what? He was a racist. Always remember England. Every time you went to war, there was black people shoulder to shoulder with you, flying your airplanes, putting in that work to kill the Germans. We was there. We put our lives on the line for this country. We came to this country, because you've got to tell us to come to this country, to build back up. We built your country back for you. So why still racism? Why are we still not accepted? Do you see what I'm saying? We've been with you lot through your wars. Every single war you've had, black people have been side by side with you. But you like to erase us out of your history and go like it was just you like that won the war. No. Buffalo soldiers. Polish people. I don't remember, it was a year ago that I heard that you were getting beat from pillar to post. Where are you? Yeah, anything that's anti-fucking fascist, be there. Stand with your brothers, innit? Do you get me? Like, I'm on a thing like this, yeah? I want every so-called gang member or whatever to put their differences aside, innit? Do you get me? Like, this is one day out of the year where you can turn around and call a truce and say, you know what? I'm gonna step for a cause that really affects me, my mum, my sister. This is gonna affect my kids' kids, the kids' kids. This is a thing that affected your grandparents, the parents before that, your ancestors. Do you understand? This face of racism. Do you hear me? I get on with everybody and anybody. I don't care what color you are. I get on with you. I love you. You feel me? I love you. Yeah? I just don't love racism. Do you understand? They hide. They come out in groups. Like, what's all that about, bro? All we want to do is just live and let live, bro. You understand? All we want to do is have a fair bite and a cherry. What's so hard in that? Do you understand? So I'm saying to all you rappers out there, yeah? Let me hear your voice. Asian man, let me hear your voice. Somalians, let me hear your voice. Polish, let me hear your voice. Turkish, hear your voice. Everybody, I want to hear your voice, bro. And I want us to turn around and show these racists that we're not having it. We don't want you here no more. You can keep that stuff outside of London, because London is multi-fucking-cultural. Yeah? It's multicultural. We get on with everybody. Yeah? We're not like these little small-minded spots all over England. We're London, bro. Do you understand? We love each other. Like,